Welcome at this CPU tutorial, how to use Certified Pickup. The start of this tutorial is our CPoint account, where I'm logged in with my username DemoMovie, and as you can see, I have already access to the Certified Pickup user interface. If you don't have access yet, you can go to our support pages, where you can find all necessary steps with the print screens, how you can request access to CPU. Through this link, I can go to the CPU user interface, as you can see right now. And on top here, you can see currently I'm logged in as a shipping agent. The core functionality of CPU starts when the ship agent gives a new commercial release through the system, which can be done through this new release button. And when I push it, you can see that in this screen, our ship agent can enter all necessary information for giving a new commercial release. When this screen is filled in and the ship agent pushes submit, the release will be translated into a release write, which will appear in his container overview. So all lines you can see here correspond with release writes. Now, the ship agent is not a party that needs that release write for pickup. No, the ship agent is required to transfer the release to the next party in line, and he or she can do that by pushing the transfer button here. As you can see, the transfer button isn't always available. It's only available when transfer is an action the ship agent can in fact do. When the release write, for example, is already transferred, the ship agent can transfer that write. So in this example, I will transfer or try to transfer this release write here to another company. I push the transfer button. So when I push this button, I see an overview of companies, which I can search based on their name, VAT number, or APCS, DUNS, and or AOE numbers. And from this list, I can select one of these companies. For example, when I want to give the release right to this company, I can push the assign button. And here I can see that the container is assigned, or the release is assigned to that certain company. Here in my overview, I see that I got the revoke button in advance. Now I have a revoke button, which means that for as long as the company I want to give the release right to hasn't accepted the release right, I can still revoke it and take the release right back to myself. When the company I want to give the release right to has accepted it, I got the status transferred here. So these are basically the steps a ship agent has to take in CPU. They create a new commercial release, we translate it into a release right, and then that release right will be transferred to another company through our user interface. And small remark, this company can be either a forwarder, in the case of merchant haulage, or the write can be transferred directly to a transporting company, in case of carrier haulage. Up next, I will change my role. So now I was a shipping agent, and now I'm going to take the role of a forwarder or a transporting company, because at this moment, both companies have the same rights, they will have the same screens in our user interface. So now I'm logged in as a forwarder. The first thing a forwarder has to do is accept the release right from the ship agent. Earlier I showed you how a ship agent can create a commercial release and transfer the release right to a forwarder. Well, in this case, that forwarder needs to accept that release right, and that he can do through its pending releases tab on the top here. And as you can see, there are two release writes pending, two writes that forwarder has to accept or even decline. When the forwarder accepts this release write, it will appear in this container overview, as was the case when the ship agent created a new commercial release, when the ship agent created a release write. So here as a forwarder, I have my overview. So let us have a look what's visible in this screen. I can see for all release writes, the bill of lading number, the container number, the ship agent that has given the commercial release. When I have received the commercial release from another party, then I see that party here. When did I receive it? What's the validity of the commercial release? So when the commercial release is in fact valid and there isn't a block on it, it's in green, otherwise it's red. On which terminal is the container positioned, or will it be positioned? Because it's perfectly possible for ship agents to give a commercial release before the container is discharged. What's the release status at the terminal? Here I can see some actions I can do on that certain container, and here I can ask details. Let's have a look at those details. So as you can see, when I click the blue square, I see the information that was entered by the ship agent here, in gray, and here those lights you can see here are the green lights column. And this gives me the status of my container. I can see if the commercial release is valid, which was the case. I can see if the container is already discharged at the terminal. Here I can see if the container is ready for pickup at the terminal, meaning that the container is available, it is discharged on the terminal, and there aren't any container blockages on it given by the terminal. For example, when my container is damaged, it's possible that the terminal says, oh, it's present, but it can't leave the terminal. Well, in that case, this light will be red. Here I have the customs light. It's a combination of CCRM and NGPS, telling me that the container isn't released by customs. When the container is fully released, the light will become green. And it's also possible that customs informs us that the container has to go to the scan. In that case, it will be a yellow light with status selected for scan. When the container leaves the terminal, the gate out light will become green. And here the final light that will disappear, but at this moment this returns information that a certain truck driver has been coupled to the system by its alpha pass. So that information is already available for all containers going through CPU. Now I can see this information for as long as I'm the current owner of the release right. But in the first phase of CPU, it's possible that, for example, I am a transporter and the forwarder I work with isn't registered on CPU, so he or she can't give me the release right. Well, in that case, I still can obtain information concerning those containers by clicking on container subscriptions here. In this tab, I can create new container subscriptions. So if I have a certain bill of lading number with a certain container number, I can create a subscription. I can see it appears in our overview. And when there is information available from a certain container, example these two, I can obtain the details by clicking the square, just as was the case when I was the release right owner. For as long as the container isn't known in our system, I can't obtain additional information, of course. But from the moment the container information is available, I can see it here. So now we've discussed our container overview, where I can find all containers I have to release right of. The pending releases, where I have to accept or decline releases that have been given to me by a previous party. We discussed our container subscriptions, where I can make a subscription to receive information from containers I'm not the release rights owner of. And here our final tab, add and annotate, we're not going to discuss it today. That's a functionality we're experimenting with at the moment, and we'll come back to that later. Now, finally, I'd like to show you the functionality I have to do as a transporter, but the functionality, as stated before, is also available for forwarders. And that is, I want to couple an alpha pass to a certain release. I want to be sure that the driver with an alpha pass with number X can pick up a container at the terminal. So first of all, to be able to do that action, I need to be the release rights owner. Release rights owner means I have to go to my container overview where I can find all containers I have the release right of. Up next, instead of transferring the release right to another company, which of course I can do, I can select pickup here, stating I know which truck driver will pick up the container at the terminal. I click pickup. I get a pop-up asking, can you give me the alpha pass number of the driver? Here I can enter an alpha pass number, push send, and then the status will change to awaiting release for pickup. When all lights are green, which lights? Well, the lights I've showed you when I showed you the detail. When those lights are green, except of course for the gate out, the container can be picked up at the terminal by the driver, which alpha pass number I've just inserted here in the system. So that concludes our demo. So long story short, ship agent can create a commercial release and can then transfer the release right he created by doing that to another company. Each other company can accept a release right from a previous company and can choose to either transfer the release right when they're not a company who will do the actual pickup, or they can select pickup here, enter an alpha pass number when they know the alpha pass number of the driver who will do the pickup. Final remark, when I am a barge or rail operator, it is enough that I am the owner of the release right to be able to send in a Coppino message to the terminal stating these are the containers I will pick up at a certain moment. Nowadays, when we have a look at the flow without CPU, there is the need for terminal to receive PIN codes in that message. You will need to enter a PIN code for all those containers. Well, when CPU is active, you don't need to fill in those PIN codes. No, for as long as you are the release right owner from those containers, so for as long as the containers are in your container overview, you can send in those Coppino messages without PIN codes, because the terminal will ask CPU, can I give these containers to this company? And when that is the case, you will receive confirmation and you can pick up those containers. Thank you.